Bizzibox's expert information on getting fit. Why is it important to get fit?
It's important to get fit for a number of different reasons. Not only does it help to stave off certain health conditions such as cardiovascular disease, osteoporosis, etc., but it's often a good idea just for everyday life, just to improve the strength of your heart, improve the strength of your muscles, to make everyday life just that much easier to get around.
How do I set myself a fitness programme?
You have to set a plan that is achievable for you and ultimately realistic. It's often after Christmas where a lot of people will say, I'm going to go to the gym 5 days a week for every day, you know, for at least 6 months a year. And of course, that's unrealistic. All intentions, good intentions might be there, but ultimately to commit to that much when you're not used to it is a huge undertaking. So it's often a good idea is just to start very, very basically to start off with and say, okay, just twice a week, 45 minutes at a go, and then increase it from there. Set yourself realistic targets and then set to increase it.
Are there any tips to keep me motivated?
Motivation tips are ultimately, it's a good idea to set yourself a particular goal, depending on what your fitness levels are. So you can either, if you're interested in running and you can't run at all, you should set yourself a goal. So to keep you motivated, if you set yourself a target of being able to run 10 kilometres, it's obvious motivation. There are plenty of events around the country where you can enter a 10 kilometre run. And by setting yourself that goal for 4, 5, 6 months' time, it's a great motivator knowing that you've got something to aim towards, a target to aim towards. Alternatively, if you're looking to lose some weight, you can just get an old pair of jeans out that you used to fit into, and you can stick them on the top of your wardrobe and say, right, there's a motivation to get back into those. And often that's a good motivator in itself.
What are the benefits of joining a gym?
But if it's joining a gym, ultimately it's a community. You can make a lot of friends at the gym. People can help motivate you through your program. There are always a good selection of fitness instructors available who you can ask questions to make sure you're doing the exercises correctly at the right intensity, and that you can get the most out of your fitness objectives and health goals.
Do I need a personal trainer?
Personal trainers are incredibly helpful if you find it difficult to motivate yourself or you're not entirely sure which direction your fitness should be going. A personal trainer will ultimately make sure that you are doing the exercises correctly, that you're performing the exercise at the correct intensity, and whatever goal you give the personal trainer, they will help you achieve it. Provided you put in the effort, they'll be able to take you all the way, whether that's being able to run a 10 kilometre or be able to lose 3 or 4 stone in weight.
How do personal trainers usually charge for their time?
Personal trainers usually charge by the hour, and rates can vary greatly. So rates can vary from £30 up to as much as £150 for certain places in London. However, because of the credit crunch, I have a feeling that some personal trainers charging that amount of money may struggle to get the business. But your general rough estimate is around about £40, £45 for an hour for a personal trainer.
How do I find a personal trainer?
It's always a good idea to find a personal trainer through word of mouth. So if you've found another trainer who's had success with a friend or a colleague, it's often good to go with them. But at the same time, it's essential that you choose a personal trainer who's got the correct qualifications. They should be at least reps level 3. Reps is the registered exercise professionals. And they should be at least level 3, should also carry valid insurance, public liability insurance, just in case there's a problem. So as long as they match those requirements, then you shouldn't have any problem with a personal trainer. But ultimately, you have to be able to strike up a good rapport with a trainer. If you have a personal trainer that's not much fun, then that training isn't going to be much fun. So you have to get the balance between somebody who's highly professional, very informed, but also someone you feel you can have a bit of a laugh with for an hour.
What is my BMI and how do I calculate it?
BMI is your body mass index, and it's a general. It's used as a general guide on whether you're overweight or not. If you want to find out your BMI, you can. It's quite easy to do. You take your weight in kilograms and divide it by your height in meters times your height. So, and you'll come up with a figure. And there are certain bands that you should be within, which will either deem you underweight, in the right bands, or overweight, or even morbidly overweight. The body mass index is quite. It's quite a raw and very rough guide on how healthy you are. For example, it doesn't take into account muscle mass. So if any members of the England rugby team decided to undertake the body mass index test, it's likely they'll come out as being clinically obese. And I'm sure the likes of James Haskell probably wouldn't appreciate that sort of sentiment. So it's used as a rough guide rather than just rely solely on as a guide to whether you're overweight or not.
How do I work out my body percentage fat?
Finding out your body fat percentages is often best done by using a personal trainer who can use a number of different measures by either using fat calipers or special pieces of equipment which send a small electric current, which you can't feel, through your body, and it can take a body fat measurement from that. You can buy scales which will give you a body fat percentage. However, they're generally very inaccurate and not really worth using. So the best way to get a body fat reading is to go to visit a personal trainer and get it recorded that way.
Are calories and fat the same thing?
Calories essentially is the amount of energy that you let off. In the strictest sense, a calorie is measured by the heat expenditure, by something either yourself, how much calories you expend, or a food substance. Fat is a food substance which contains the highest number of calories. There are 9 calories per gram of fat, compared with 4 calories in a gram of carbohydrates and 4 calories in a gram of protein. So ultimately, fat contains a very high amount of calories per gram. So it's often why it's very difficult to shift excess body fat, because you've got to expend a lot of energy to get rid of it.
How often and for how long should I exercise per week?
Very much depends how fit you want to get on how many days a week you should exercise, really. Ultimately, you should be aiming for generally 3 times a week, at least 45 minutes of reasonably high intensity exercise. However, it's important to point out that it really is the quality of exercise you perform rather than the quantity. You could easily go for an hour and a half workout of low intensity, but if it's not productive, you could easily get the same or better benefits from doing a 45-minute workout or even 30-minute workout. So it's not always length of time, it's what you do with your time while you're exercising.
What intensity of training do I need to do to achieve results?
Intensity of training is a fairly contentious subject. Ultimately, it's a better idea to train on the higher side, mainly because the body responds far better. When you train at a high intensity, you secrete hormones which help to burn fat that much more effectively. Plus, when you train at a high intensity, your basal metabolic rate is increased that much more after you stop exercising. So a high intensity workout is incredibly effective at burning fat and increasing your fitness levels, as opposed to low intensity. So if you've got the choice between going for a walk or a run, intensity-wise, I'd go for a run.
What is my basal metabolic rate?
Basal metabolic rate is the rate at which your body expends energy through its own physiological sources. So the energy it takes for your liver to function, your kidneys to function, your heart to beat, every bodily process. And as a rough guide, for women it's around about 1,500 calories a day. For men it's around about 2,000 calories a day. However, these figures are very, very rough guides. Is the more muscle mass you have, the higher your metabolic rate is. So it's a very, very rough guide.
How do I prevent and treat muscle soreness?
Actually, very difficult to prevent muscle soreness. There was often a thought that by stretching out muscles, it would help to reduce muscle soreness. However, the reason for muscle soreness is by performing weight training or any form of resistance work where your muscles are overloaded, they become slightly inflamed. There are ever such small micro tears within the fibers. And it's this inflammatory response of the body which causes the muscles to feel sore, often 48 hours after a workout as opposed to the next day. It's something called DOMS, delayed onset muscle soreness, and unfortunately there's not a huge amount you can do to prevent it. However, once your body becomes more accustomed to exercise, then you'll find that the delayed onset muscle soreness is far reduced and you can work out without walking around crippled.
What basic equipment do I need to work out at home?
Working out at home is a really good idea if you've got the discipline to be able to do it. Often a lot of people find it very difficult to work out at home with all the distractions around. But really, if you want to work out at home, you've got to choose a piece of equipment that you enjoy doing. A rowing machine is a fantastic thing to have at home. They can be stored away and brought out whenever you need them. But of course, if you dislike rowing, then there's no point in having one because you won't end up using it. But really, to do simple exercises, you can do. All you need to do is to get an exercise ball and do a whole range of exercises on an exercise ball. So you don't really need a lot of equipment in order to get fit in the comfort of your own home.
Can I have personal training at home?
Absolutely. A lot of trainers will travel to your home and they will be able to design an exercise regime specifically for your health goals. This will vary from client to client. So every now and again, the client may decide to have a run and then do exercises inside with the trainer. Or if you have a piece of equipment, use equipment inside. So if you choose to have a trainer at home, explain your fitness goals to the trainer, and they will design a program specifically for you that you should be able to do in the comfort of your own home as well when they're not there.
How much does a personal trainer usually cost?
The cost of a personal trainer does vary. It's anywhere between £30 and £50, £60, generally speaking. Around about the middle of that is about normal. So around about £40 to £45 per hour for a personal trainer.
How much does a gym membership usually cost?
Once again, gym memberships vary depending on whether it's council run or whether it's a private company. Gym memberships can cost anywhere from £35 a month up to as much as £80 a month. But obviously, generally speaking, the more you pay, the more facilities you could expect to receive, such as a swimming pool, a spa, a squash court, etc. So anywhere between £30 to £80 a month.
How do I measure my progress and results?
It's often a good idea, once again, to have, if you have a fitness instructor, when they first assess you in a gym, they will find out what your abilities are. And every now and again, you should be reassessed at a gym to find out how your fitness levels have improved. Fitness levels can be measured in a variety of different ways. It depends what your fitness levels ultimately are. Generally, heart rate is used. So for example, if you tried to jog for a mile initially, you can see what your heart rate was then. And then 6 weeks, 8 weeks later, you can do the same jog and see what your heart rate is again after that. So you'll know that you're getting fitter if your heart rate is much more reduced for the second run, because it shows your heart's become that much stronger and it's that much more efficient at being able to perform the exercise that your body's asking of it.
www.bizzybox.com